So let's say in IPC, there are you know, these topics called semaphore, mailbox, timing region, and program block interface. Interface is an entity which is used for, you know, DUT and the test bench to be communicate with each other. So interface is kind of a static entity where once it gets created, you cannot remove it. And you know, class is a dynamic entity if you know its properties. So interface is a static entity once it gets created, and so you cannot remove it. So it will exist throughout the simulation, and it will exist throughout all the test cases. So for that we use virtual interface, and in interface we have mode port and clocking block. So these are the topics we will cover in the IPC. So today we will cover the semaphore and mailbox. So if we talk about the semaphore, semaphore has four functions. So once you declare the semaphore, you create the semaphore, and you know, the get method is like how many keys you want in the bucket. And the, wait. Okay, so let's see, you know, there's a module block. In module block, you have the semaphore, you have declared the semaphore. Then in the initial begin block, you have created the semaphore with the number of keys. How many? So the number of keys means, suppose you have created, you know, something, like I'll give an example. Suppose there are two things. So the, you know, there are two persons, they both wants to use one resource. So for that, they have one common entity, which is called the key. So for to access that resource, you need the key to access it. So here in the fork join, basically there are two functions called display. Okay. And both of them are having the same definition. In that we have this get method sema.get. Sema is like, you know, it's handle, semaphore's handle, which says get method, which we have get method, you know, by default we have one key. So basically in the fork join, these two functions will get executed parallelly. Okay, so sema.get, in that case, you know parallelly these two functions will get executed, but you know, either one of them will get executed, because in the get method, by default you can have one key with the get method. So you know, once the get method will get the key, and you know, it will start the execution, and at the end of this task, you know, it will put that key in the bucket. Okay, so once it returns the key, then the second process will get executed again. Is this topic, I mean, okay, so basically, you know, this new method we use to create the semaphore, and the get method to obtain one or more keys from the bucket to start the process, to start the method, you know, the further execution, we need the get method. So in the get method, we define how many number of keys are available in the bucket how many number of keys are available in the bucket so that we can further execute the function or task. In the put method, once the task has executed, and it will return the keys in the bucket. So basically I'll say there are two person who wants to access the same resource. So that, you know, to access the same resource, that resource allows, you know, each person to have two keys. Okay, so any of one of them can access the the resource at a time. Okay, suppose there are a person, let me share my screen, okay? Explain you by paint diagram. You able to see my screen, right? The paint. Okay, suppose this is a bucket. Okay, I'll say it as a semaphore bucket. So there are two person, I'll call A and B. Okay, so you know, this semaphore says, this bucket says, like, to access this resource, each one must have two keys to access it. So once I created the semaphore with the two keys. So whenever I call this function, suppose the, you know, let's see, in a generic way, you know, both A and B wants to access this resource. So when A wants to access the resource, it must have two keys. Okay, otherwise it will reject the access. When B wants to access it, it also has, you know, two keys. So, you know, both A and B have two keys. A also has two keys and B also have two keys. Okay, in that case, you know, they will access this resource. So basically this get method is, you know, it says, you know, how many number of keys are required to access the semaphore. Okay, once you execute it, then you, whatever the keys you use, you have to put those keys into the bucket again. For that we have to use this put method, and I'll show in the example. So in the module block, we have created the semaphore. In the initial begin, we have created with the new method. So basically, whenever we call the semaphore, this resource, okay. So here, you know, one key is a must. We should have one key at least in our get method. Then only we will be able to access this. So in the fork join block, we have two display tasks. Okay, and, you know, both the display task has the same definition. So either one will get executed. Okay, both will get start. So the task, you know, this, you know, for this one also, for, you know, process one and process two, the execution will start, but for one, it will stop whenever the sema.get will occur, because there were only one key which is used by either one of this process. Okay, so if you see the, so after that, so basically process one or process two, either one will get executed, then once process one get executed, it will return that, you know, that key back into the bucket, and the, you know, once it returns back into the bucket, the process two will get executed. Did you guys get it? Hello?
Yes, Pawan, we got it.
Okay. So let's see the other example. Suppose we have created the semaphore with the four number of keys. Okay. And we have the same two functions in the fork join. Okay. Then in the task, we have here in the get method, we have defined how many number of keys we need to get that function executed. So here, you know, to further execution of this function, we need at least four keys in the bucket. So four keys we used. So either one process will get executed and the second process will wait for this current process to be finished. So once it returns, back into the bucket these keys, then only the other process will get executed. Okay, so let's see. We have created a semaphore, okay, and with one number of keys. There is only one key we have created in the bucket. We have only one key, so we have three functions with different number of keys. So here in the process one and process two and process three. So each task, so basically each task has different number of requirement. So the process one says one key. So to get this task executed, you must have one key in the bucket to get this process one to be executed. So basically all these three processes will start executing, but they will stop at this point. You're able to see my cursor, so not focus on my cursor. So they will stop here. So the display one will get executed because there is a one number of keys already available in the bucket. So once it gets finished, so here when it is putting, when it is returning back to the semaphore, it will key plus one. So basically key means it will return two keys in the bucket, so that the require in the, for the process two, we need two keys to execute this task number two. In the third process, we have again, we have already two keys. So two plus one, it will return three keys. Do you guys have any doubt? I can explain in that within. In simple words, it's like you create a resource with certain number of keys. So whoever wants to access that resource needs to have certain number of keys. If those number of keys are available with that person, then he can access it. And when it, the execution of the, so basically at the initial phase, in the initial phase of a task, it has to show like how many number of there will be get method which shows which triggers like whether you can continue executing that function or task or not. At the end of that task, you have to put those keys back into the bucket. Any doubt or something here? Hello, may I know the answer?
No doubt, sir.
Okay. So in the same way, we have the mailbox also. So semaphore and mailbox are the similar things which are used to communicate with two processes. So basically these are like communication mechanism between, you can say, the sequencer or the, you can say, generator or the driver in case of system Verilog. So mailbox is a communication mechanism that allows messages to be exchanged between processes. So mailbox are two types, bounded and unbounded. Bounded and unbounded based on the category of its size. So when the limited size, then mailbox has limited size, then it will be bounded, and it doesn't have, if the size is not defined in that, it will be unbounded mailbox. So generic mailbox and parameterized mailbox, there are other category of mailboxes. So generic means it can exchange any kind of data, or parameterized, it will it will allow processes to exchange the data of particular type. So let's see. So in system Verilog, mainly we have packet class, we have generator class, we have driver class, and we have top. Okay, so here we have address and data in the packet class. Let's see. So in the packet class, we can, you know, we can define the, you know, post randomize, whatever the after randomization, whatever the, you know, value of address and data gets. So if this function gets executed after the randomization, so that is like post randomize. So let's see in the generator where we create the test cases, you can say that. So we have created the mailbox here. Okay. Then in the constructor, we have passed the mailbox and we have this key with the, this keyword. We have, you know, whatever we have created here in the, you know, handle of mailbox, we have assigned here. Basically, this we will call in the top.
And the, so are you presenting something?
Yes, I'm presenting something. You able to see it?
So it is paint is open, so right now.
Oh, is it paint is open now?
Okay, yes, that's fine.
Wait. Okay, so from here, I'll explain from here. Okay, let's go back here. Okay, mailbox is a kind of thing. You're able to see the paint now?
No, sir, nothing is.
Nothing is there.
No, sir, it is not presenting.
Okay, then wait. Now, you say, okay, you confirm with me.
Yes, now it is.
Okay, okay. So let's say, okay, from scratch, let's discuss the mailbox, okay? So basically, there are four components in the system Verilog test bench. Okay, so here the this packet is here this component is packet, this is generator, and this is driver, okay, which drives the stimulus to the DOT here. Okay, so in the packet, whatever the fields we use to you know write a test case, we define here in the packet class. Okay. So here in the generator, we define our test cases. Okay. So basically in driver, we synchronize. Okay. When we drive to the onto the interface actually. So let's see. We have created a packet here. Basically the fields, we have defined our fields in the packet class here. The mailbox will, you know, exchange the data between generator and driver. So basically, something, and let's see, in a test case, in a single scenario, where this generator generates a particular stimulus, and at the, you know, at the same time, this driver wants to fetch that data from the generator. Basically, generator will generate something and it will put into this mailbox. Okay. At the same time, it will fetch, this driver will fetch that data from the mailbox and it will drive to the interface. Okay. Now, let's see here. Now you guys able to see my screen? The other, I opened another PPT.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, let's see. Okay, this is the packet class where I have two fields, address and data. Okay, this is the post randomize function, which is called after randomization. So the value of address and data will be printed once when we call this. Okay, when once we randomize it. Okay, so in the generator class, what did I do is, I have created an instance of packet class, and in the, you know, I have created the mailbox, and in the, you know, in the constructor of the generator, I have passed mailbox. Okay. And in the run phase, okay, in the run phase, okay, I'm calling twice. The generator is, you know, basically, okay, let's see here. So packet new, like it's like instantiation of a packet class. Okay, here packet is being packet is being randomized. So the value of address and data could be anything in this limit, 7:0. So basically, once this value get packet dot value of address and data gets randomized, so am dot box, this is the mailbox handle. You know, the whatever the value of address and data is being randomized, you know, that data will be put into the mailbox. Okay, and this is the dollar display statement which will give you the notification that it has put into the mailbox. Okay, so it will repeat twice. So every time it randomizes, it puts into the mailbox. Okay, let's see in the driver class. I did the same thing here. I declared the packet and mailbox here. Here in the constructor, I assigned the, you know, the mailbox. Basically, this mailbox handle I assigned whatever I will pass it to the driver in the top. So here in this run phase, am_box.get. And when, okay, let's see here. You go here. So here in the run phase, it will repeat twice. So let's see, once in the first repetition, it will randomize it. It will put into the packet. So basically here, let's see, at the first time it randomize it, it will put the value of address and data into the mailbox here. Okay, that data at the same time, mailbox.get here, this function is also being called by the driver. You getting it? So at that time, packet will received from the mailbox. This driver got the packet from the mailbox. And here we can see the data, whatever the data we have got here. Okay, and you know how, you know, both the things will be synchronized, or they will be managed by the top. You can in the module. Okay, so we have the generator, driver, and the mailbox here. So generator will generate some packets, and the driver will fetch the data from the mailbox. So let's see in the initial begin block. So we have created the mailbox here. We instantiated it. Okay, we have created the mailbox. Basically, we have allocated some memory to the mailbox, so where the generator can generate some values to those packets and put those into the mailbox. Here, when we are calling generator, okay, when we are instantiating, okay, in that case, we are passing mailbox handle. So here in the constructor of driver and mailbox, here we are passing. Okay, in the driver also, we are doing the same thing. Here in the fork join block, generator.run, okay, those, the generator.run and driver.run, you know, these two processes will execute concurrently, you know, parallelly. So generator.run and driver.run, you know, those two tasks will get executed at the same time. So the, you know, the repetition of the generator's run phase, or you can say the run task, will, you know, it will, you know, generator will, you know, generate the some random values and put into the mailbox. At the same time, driver will request to the mailbox, whatever the data comes to the mailbox, it wants to fetch that data from the mailbox. Okay, this is how it happens in the mailbox. Do you guys have any doubt? I can explain. Hello.
Do we have to write this module like for mailbox separately also?
What, can you speak little louder?
Sir, means what we have written here, like module, top module. So that top module is top now, or you have
top module here? Is to control the generator and the mod generator and the driver. You know, to start the you know stimulus here.
Okay, sir.
So basically, you want to control, like you want to use the mailbox. It's like the appropriate use of mailbox here, where suppose you know there are two people. Okay, they wants to share the data, but they cannot directly you know talk to each other. They are not allowed to talk to each other. They want to use some common resource. So suppose the person A and B, so A will generate some data and it will give it to the some person C. At the same time, the B will request for the same data to the C. You know, it's like that.
Okay, sir.
So basically, you know, mailbox, and you might have heard about the pipelining concept. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So basically, these are the very significant topics to implement the pipelining concept.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So any other doubt I can explain? Yeah, these are the very important topic of like system Verilog, mailbox and semaphore. I mean, these are very simple as well. Basically, you know, everything is you know simple. Other than the IPC, IPC is the you know is you know in system Verilog it makes everything differ. Where these concepts you are going to use in the UVM and all.
Okay, sir.
Any doubt from semaphore and mailbox? Let me, you know, conclude something from the semaphore and mailbox. Okay. So, you know, both are very similar mechanisms. In case of semaphore, there is a common, you know, there is basically suppose the, you know, let's see. This is the person C. This is the person. This is person A and B, okay, in a generic way I'm saying. So let's see, they both wants to go to some place. A and B wants to go to this same place, okay. So C has a car. So either A can take that car or the B can take the car, right? So once you know, suppose A and B wants to go to some place, for that A should have, you know, the key. So basically to get that key, they should have one key at least. A and B should have a key. So C has created one car and that also with one key. So, you know, A will go to the C and ask for the car. It has one key. B also, if A and B can go together, they cannot access that car. They cannot have that car together, right? So either one has to get that car. So once A has to go, it can get the access. It can use that car and it has to come back and returns that car to the C. Then it then the B can access that resource. It's like that in case of semaphore. In case of mailbox, suppose A and B wants to communicate. So they, you know, this is the mailbox. Let's see, this is the mailbox. Here A will generate something. It will put that data into that mailbox and B will come at the same time or in that period of time, B will try to, we will be requesting to this mailbox either A has sent the data or not. The time the data has come from the A, the B will access the data. So A will generate some package and it will put into the mailbox. Once it puts into the mailbox, we will get those data and it will utilize it. Okay, so this is the simple difference between mailbox and semaphore. Both are the communication mechanisms which are used to exchange the, you know, data between two processes or between two components. And these are used for the pipe to implement the pipelining concept in case of AHB and AXI protocols and all, where you want to, you know, to implement the high throughput.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Let's discuss about the interface as well. Okay, I'll tell you in a simple way, okay, interface and all. The PPTs and all I'll prepare later in the next class. Okay, interface is a static entity where the class is a dynamic entity. So dynamic entity means if you want to use that class, you can use it, you can declare it, and you can instantiate it. Once you use it, you destroy it. But interface is a physical entity. Once it gets created, it will exist throughout. But you cannot use the interface into the class. Basically, class is a dynamic entity and interface is a static entity, which you cannot declare interface into the class. For that, we use the virtual interface. To get the virtual interface, we use the config DB, UVM. Like in case of UVM, we use the UVM config DB kind of things. So here in the word interface, we define two things, mod port and clocking blocks. So let's see if I explain you the, interface thing. So let's see, this is the. This is the test bench. This is the DUT. DUT here means design. Okay. Here it's test bench. Okay. So basically in this, you will be having driver and all. Driver will be a class. This is a DUT. It will be a design. So they cannot directly, you can communicate with the DUT with two things. It could be the ports like TLM ports and all, or you can communicate with the interface. Okay. So here the interface will come into the picture. Okay. So here the interface will come into the picture. Interface will have two things. So mod port and clocking blocks. Mod ports will tell you about the directional information. Means which port is used for which, either it is used for input or output. So mod port will be used for directional information, whether it will be used for input or output. There will be a clocking block as well. Okay, which will tell you about the timing information. Okay, so the clocking block, clocking block will tell you about at what time the data has to be sampled and what time it has to be fetched. So that we called as a clock skew. So interface has two important things, mod port and clocking blocks. A mod port tell about the directional information, which port is used for the input and output, and the clocking block will tell you about the timing information. When the data to be sampled and when the data to be, driven. And here we have the program block. Program block, you might have heard about the program block and the module block. So program block executes you might have heard about the timing regions. In case of system Verilog, we have the timing region. In case of UVM, we have the phases. Like if I tell about the UVM phases are like, there'll be build phase, there'll be connect phase, there'll be run phase. So in case there are three types of phases in the UVM, like end of elaboration, connect phase, build phase, and startup, simulation. In case of run phase, run phase, there'll be run phases, and there'll be clean phase, there'll be check phase, report phase, final phase, and all. But in case of system Verilog, we have scheduling semantics, which are like, there are regions which are very important, like prepon region, active region, inactive region, observed region, reactive region, re-inactive region, and postpon region. Okay, I'll ask you a simple thing. Do you guys know the difference between blocking and non-blocking, assignment statements?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can somebody tell? I'll better explain you. I'll explain you in a better way if you guys tell. What is the difference between them? Major difference?
Sir, okay, so how it function is different. So in blocking, like we consider there are four blocking statements. So blocking statement first will be executed, and the other blocking statements will be blocked until the execution and assignment of that statement happens. And in non-blocking, all the assignments will be executed simultaneously, and the assignment will happen in non-blocking region. So this in the scheduling semantics. So
exactly.
But in that blocking, it will happen in that active region only.
Okay. Yeah, I'll explain you that. Okay. Basically, the blocking and non-blocking, both the kind of assignment statements will be evaluated in the active region only. Okay. Yes. But the assignment, in case of non-blocking assignment statements, it will happen in the NBA region, non-blocking NBA region.
Yes.
Okay. That is the major difference. So these are the time regions. So in the prepon region, they are like in the active region, there are, I'll explain if you see here. Oh, wait. So basically, I know this program, we were talking about the program block. So program block executes in the reactive region, dollar display gets executed in the active region. So, there are differences based on the keywords and keywords and the task and functions and all. So here in the, if I talk about the IPC, there are, important things are semaphore, mailbox, interface and scheduling semantics. Okay. If you talk about the classes and sir, the, hello. OPS concepts.
Hello, yeah. Sir, where is this program block used? Like in practical sense.
Program block is used to avoid the race around conditions. Okay. Where it tells the clear, very clear predictions between the test bench and the DUT.
Okay, sir. Like I searched something on Quora, and that someone is there. I don't, Ramdas, something like that name. He told like he hasn't used this program block. Like in
even
his,
I've been working since last 3 years. I'm currently working in Intel. So even I didn't use this program block, but program block is being executed in this reactive region, which tells you exactly like there will be no, what we call it is, there will be no conflict.
To avoid race around conditions.
Yeah, to avoid the race around conditions.
And sir, this clocking block is also used for the same, like to avoid race around conditions.
Clocking block is used inside the interface. It will be defined in the, suppose clocking block, suppose you want to put some data into the interface. So what you going to do? you will be okay. I'll show you an example. Okay, maybe I may have it. So let's see. It's a driver's code. Okay, so let's see here. Okay, this. Oh, maybe. Wait. Okay, so let's see here. This VIF is handle of virtual interface. Okay, so let's see. This is my actual interface. You able to see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Where I opened the driver's code. So this is my actual interface which I'm talking about. This is VIF is a handle of virtual interface. So I am declaring this physical interface as virtual. If I don't declare it in as virtual, then I cannot use here in this class. Class is a dynamic entity where interface is a static entity. So something which is dynamic, inside that I cannot declare static. It's very common thing, right?
Yes, sir.
So I used virtual interface here. So basically I want to, so in the driver, what is the role of driver? Driver sends the data to the interface, right?
Yes,
so
sir.
Suppose I want to send some data to the interface here in the here. Suppose in case of you, I don't know whether you guys are familiar with the APB or not. So basically in the address, what I'm doing here in the address, I want to send a packet to the interface. So what I'm going to do is I will access that port from the interface. Then whatever I have, you know, randomized or whatever the packet I have created, that I will assign here. So I address P address this signal dot VIF is like, you know, handle to the virtual interface, then driver underscore clock. So at that time I will basically I'm assigning, you know, some value to the virtual interface, basically to the interface via virtual interface.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is how we use the virtual interface in that.
Sir, I asked about sir clocking block. Like clocking block is also used for to avoiding the race condition, no? Because we are
yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So basically, when you define the timing, what time you want to drive something onto the interface, then it is like obvious that you are avoiding race around condition. Like race around condition is the conflict between two things.
Okay, sir.
So I was explaining about the IPC, right? IPC, there are, you know, these are the important things. Semaphore, mailbox, program block, like even like I have 3 years of experience, like even I didn't use so far. Virtual interface and interface will be very important, and scheduling semantics, you should know where, why, you know, dollar, why, what is the difference between a forever block and always block and all. So those differences you should know that, and program block and the module block and all, so that you can understand clearly based on the scheduling semantics only. Okay, if I talk about the classes, then there are, you know, shallow copy and deep copy. I feel this is very important, shallow copy and deep copy. So this is the other than that, everything seems normal only. You know this keyword when you have, you know, conflict of same data type or same data field in the, you know, when the you know, there is a field, you know, a class. Let's see, we discussed that, right? So here in this, see, this is a class, you know, mailbox has, you know, handle as a mailbox, right? Am underscore box. Here the function also have am underscore box. So when you want to access the class variable, then you have to use the this keyword inside this function. You get it?
Yes, sir.
So this keyword is used for that, to make the difference. And let's see, this constructors are used to initialize, you know, the class properties actually. So if we say, suppose this is a class, okay, here, you're able to see this driver class here, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so basically what happens, you know, this driver class is extended from UVM driver, right? So this is the constructor for this class. So you want this class to get some memory. So for that, we have to use this constructor. And this super keyword is to initialize the class properties of its parent class.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then parameterized classes and all, like we have to, you know, let's see, this driver class is a parameterized class. So this trans one, you get it? Trans one is like, you know, packet class where we want to pass some data to the driver. So you know how data travels in the test bench, like there will be a packet class where we will be having certain number of fields. So those fields will be traveling to the you know sequence. Packet will be a class where we define all the data fields. Then it will be you know, we will use those data fields to make a test case in the sequence class. Then we will send them to the sequence. Then we will send from sequence to the driver. So those classes to be are of parameterized class. So here we use the, you know, hash sign to make that class as a parameterized class. So basically here, this driver class is a parameterized class which accepts the data of this class type. So parameterized class means, you know, particular type of the class will be having this particular class of data. Inheritance means we can call its properties, you know, there'll be child class and base class. So the child class can inherit its, you know, the parent class properties. So there'll be, you know, multiple things in that. Casting, when we change from one data type to the another data type. Abstract class and virtual methods. This is important here. Okay, Adana, we can cover in the next slide with some examples. This won't take more than one class. Then, you know, randomization and constraints. You guys have any, you know, particular doubt with respect to the system Verilog? We can discuss them.
Sir, I have one doubt. Like, I know these concepts, like what are these things basically, but how to use all those things and make a build up like a good test bench, where to use, like, so that flow is missing, sir.
So yes, basically, sir, you can work on a project, right?
Yes,
basically, sir. I'll tell you, okay, with my experience, I'll tell you, you know, these are the concepts which are very, very important. Okay. Like, you won't study this interface when you will be studying, you know, APB, AHB, I2C, UART, SPI and all. You won't be studying, you won't get what is the program block. But you start, you work on a very simple project. I'll tell you, APB, you can work, you can start working on AHB Lite, you can start working on AXI and all. So basically, let's talk about the AHB protocol. Yes, where, you know, AHB is a pipeline protocol, right? So
yes,
when you will be implementing pipelining, now there you will see these processes, you will see the usage of these fork join, you know, these concepts. You will see the usage of interface, you will see the usage of mailbox or semaphore. You will see the usage of interface in this virtual interface. You will see the usage of this abstract classes or virtual methods.
Okay, sir. But the most of the projects that I look on Google, and they are in UVM, like they use UVM concepts. Like APB also UVC, I found, like, but it was in not a system very long exactly. It was using concepts of UVM.
So frankly speaking, you know, every project is made it in UVM only because it's simple and you know, industry is adopting it. Industry, like, you know, driven by UVM only. Like all the test bench environments, you will see in the UVM only. I like I'm working Intel right now, so like I didn't see anything in the SV. Concepts are like SV oriented, but you know, the framework is still UVM only. Where you will see the driver, you will see the monitor, you will see the, you know, scoreboard and all. There will be different monitors. You will see the different drivers, categories of there. You will see the different scoreboards, black box for scoreboard, white box scoreboard and all.
Okay, sir. Sir, one more doubt I have. Like, sir, it is not clear to me. Like, what is the what is that transaction packet or sequence? Like, what is
okay?
That?
Okay, transaction packet and sequence. Okay,
yes, sir.
So this
and how it is and how it is different from that pin level. Like, driver is used to that get the packet and give it to the pins. So
okay. This is like, you know, you might have heard the handshake mechanism between sequence, sequencer, and driver. You get that? Okay,
yes,
let me explain you guys here. It should be here. Let me see.
Sir, it is on that also. Chief verify also.
Okay, you can. Wait. You can send a link into the chat. I can open that.
Okay, sir. Let me.
Yeah. Or I can open the simplest example. Okay, here I opened it. You come to my screen.
Okay, sir.
Here. So basically, you know, sequence is there. This is sequencer and the driver. Okay. If I make a, you know, let me give a little brief about UVM here. Okay. So basically, you know, we have, you know, there is a DUT. Okay. This is our DUT. Okay, my, you know, I cannot draw properly here. I'm drawing with my mouse. Okay. So here in this, there will be an agent. Okay. Agent has three components, sequence and driver and monitor.
Sequencer, driver, and monitor. Yes, sir.
Sequence will be outside of agent. Okay.
Yes,
so this will be under environment. Okay. So here this sequencer and this driver. So basically this sequencer, this is a sequencer. Okay. This one is sequencer and they will be connected with the TLM ports.
So
here this will be TLM export. This will be TLM port. What?
Sir, sequence is inside environment or it is inside test? like it is inside
this test. Sequencer is
not sequencer. So sequence
will be under test, not yes. under the, you know, this is a test. Okay, so basically this is a test where you will have a scoreboard. What you are asking is this sequence is under the test or under agent, right? Or environment. This will be yes. under test, not under the environment. This yes. will be outside of the environment. Okay, this is like, you know, yes. basic I'm telling you. So test will have your scoreboard and your agent. Agent will have three components called monitor, sequencer and driver. Okay, so here this sequence, this is the sequence where you write your test cases. Okay, so sequence, when you will write a test case, now you will use some fields. Fields means you will use data, you will use address. Basically, you will use address, data and some control informations, whether you want to write, whether you want to read and how you want to write, in which constraints you want to write. Okay, those will be defined in the sequence item. We call it this class as sequence item. You can call these as a transaction class, you can call it as a packet class, you can call it as sequence item class, whatever you want.
Okay, sir. So in sequence item, we have like, means how we will be writing, how will we like
no, read in that? Sequence item, you will have data fields which you are going to use in your test bench. Like suppose you will have a data, so first thing you will have an address, second thing you will have an data, third thing you will have some control informations. Control information means how you want to drive the data into your DUT, that you will have it. Shall I show you an example?
Yes sir.
Okay, wait. Okay, wait. Let me open it. I'll show you.
Okay,
yeah, one second, I need to explain something here. Okay. Let me know when you are able to see it, okay?
Okay, sir. It is visible.
Okay. Oh, sorry. Okay, see here. So you're able to see my screen, right? So this is the address, you have a data, you have these are the control informations with respect to APB.
Yes, sir.
Okay, here you are, what you are doing, you are defining what are the fields you are going to use further in your test bench. So the sequence item class is same as packet class, where you define your fields.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you guys can ask any doubt or something if you have. Thank you. Hello, Rajat.
Yes.
Yeah, I think let's wrap it up.
Yeah, sure. We can wrap it up. Okay, thank you guys. Thank you so much.